Honestly, I'm starting to forget what it's like to wear a pair of pants without a drawstring waistband, and I don't mind it. There is such a fine line between clever and stupid. That's immortal rock god David St. Hubbins in a great quote. And it's that quote that keeps running through my mind as I watch the increasing number of protests across the country against what some believe to be too strict quarantine guidelines issued by governors to slow the spread of coronavirus. So are these protests organic expressions of legitimate unhappiness over government overreach into people's lives, even amid a highly transmissible global pandemic? Or are they dangerous incitements by manipulating protesters who are risking their lives and others with their actions? Well, President Trump has already made up his mind on it.
Some governors have gone too far. Some of the things that happened are maybe not so appropriate.
Trump has also said that protesters are, quote, listening to me, and that they, quote, seem to be protesters that like me, end quote. Okie dokie. Now, the actual answers to the questions posed by these protests around the country are much, much more complex than Donald Trump makes them out to be. So let's try to get to the bottom of it all. And the best place to start that is, well, at the start, which, weirdly enough, is in Lansing, Michigan in early April. Michigan Democratic Governor Gretchen Whitmer had issued an executive order on April 9th that not only extended the stay-at-home order in place in the state already, but also put several other restrictions in place, including these. One, no gatherings of any people who are not part of a single household. Two, no travel to in-state vacation or second homes. Three, large stores can only have four customers for every 1,000 square feet of floor space, and they must close all areas dedicated to carpeting, flooring, furniture, garden centers, plant nurseries, or paint, and you can't use motorboats or jet skis. Now, those new guidelines were immediately met with unhappiness. And within days, thousands of cars had descended on the state capitol, including on the actual state capitol lawn, for some reason, to protest Whitmer's new rules. The whole effort was known as Operation Gridlock. Sidebar, that's a weird name for a protest since there is literally no traffic anywhere in the country. Maybe they were being ironic? And sidebar. Signs of protesters carried blared slogans like, "Liberty once lost is lost forever," "Security without liberty is called prison," and "Recall Whitmer." That's all according to the Detroit Free Press. Malachi Barrett, a reporter for MLive.com, described the scene as, quote, "half protest, half Trump rally." Whitmer, in an interview with CNN, called Operation Gridlock a political demonstration, but added that, quote, "I don't wish them ill will. I'm trying to protect all the people of this state, no matter if they voted for me or not," end quote.
Looks a lot like a political rally out there, as opposed to something that really is about the substance of the stay-home order and why it's important that we take this aggressive stance with COVID-19.
So Whitmer's point, which was proven out by photos and videos of the protesters in Lansing, was that by gathering in large groups and many without wearing protective masks, those most agitated about the quarantine restrictions were greatly increasing their chances of actually contracting the coronavirus. That obvious bit of logic aside, Michigan served as a spark that quickly caught fire in a number of other states. Within days, similar protests had popped up in Ohio, Kentucky, Minnesota, North Carolina, and Utah, and Texas. And Trump, as he so often does, poured lighter fluid over the growing conflagration. He sent a trio of tweets like this. One, "Liberate Michigan," he tweeted. Then, "Liberate Minnesota," he tweeted. Then, "Liberate Virginia and save your great Second Amendment. It is under siege," he tweeted. Now, that Trump fire was further stoked by Fox News, which has extensively covered the protesters as nothing more than freedom-loving individuals. Here's Jeanine Pirro on Sean Hannity's Fox News show.
"Keep us away from churches and synagogues. They want to make sure we don't go back to work. They don't get it. The American spirit is too strong and Americans are not going to take it."
Fox News' Laura Ingraham tweeted similar encouragement to protesters, writing, quote, "Time to get your freedom back," end quote. Now, the idea that these protesters are simply average American citizens frustrated with the impositions being foisted upon them by the state government is belied somewhat by the involvement of InfoWars founder Alex Jones at a protest in Austin, Texas, and the presence of the Proud Boys, a far-right organization, at another rally. Not to mention the Confederate flags flying all over and the anti-Semitic signs. Asked directly about the appearance of hate groups at these protests, Trump said this.
"They've got cabin fever. They want to get back. They want their life back. Their life was taken away from them. And, you know, they learned a lot during this period. They learned to do things differently than they have in the past. And, you know, they'll do it hopefully until the virus has passed." I've seen American flags all over the place. I have never seen so many American flags at a rally as I have at the Israelis. These people love our country, they want to get back to work.
The truth is that Trump is embracing and encouraging these protests, no matter who is going to them, because it serves his political interests. It aligns him quite clearly on the side of outsiders irate at the political establishment and helps reinforce his belief that America needs to get back to normal, even with the risks of starting another major coronavirus epidemic. Trump doesn't much care why most of the protesters are there or what they're really advocating. What he cares about is their rage and channeling it to his political benefit. And that is The Point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday right here at my house. Check them all out.